cleaned up by the local education authority?
That's a good question. you're getting a round of applause from the Treasurer. It's not often that happens at Community Cabinet, so he's at one with you on this agenda. The debate now, I mean, we have over five long years worked out a new system of school funding. When I say 5 years, it's taken us 5 years to show school by school what's been achieved in schools, 5 years to show the resources available in the school. When we came to government, no one could tell you how schools were going, where the most disadvantaged schools were, that information just didn't exist. So we put it all together, and then we showed, by working in a targeted series of schools, what can be achieved when you put in new resources and you combine that with some new ways of working, you can really lift the standards for the kids. Now we want to do that in every school around the country, all 9,500 of them, get it right for the future, stop the sort of politics that can happen between school systems, get it right for every school. So that's a school resource standard with loadings for things like disadvantage, which we know make a difference to children's education and means that you need more resources to teach them. The debate now isn't with us, because we're so determined to get this done. It's to make sure that we get states and territories signing on. We're so determined to get it done, we're prepared to put in $2 for every one that they put in. And I can be very clear that we are going to make sure that money passes through state governments and gets into schools. We won't be signing up agreements that allow state government bureaucracies to keep money in record amounts or anything like that. We'll be making sure that there are proper arrangements so state education departments have the resources they need, but that they are not keeping money that should have gone to schools. We'll also be making sure that it's not we're tipping money in and state governments are taking money out, that there are no more cuts. And, and the people in this audience tonight, Bob, you're a question, and we've got a lot of work to do. We're just going to take a couple of last questions. I'm sorry, we are really running out of time, but I did promise the lady here, and I know just you in the front row. Yes, absolutely. Yes, Heather.
My name's Heather Lawson, I'm deafblind, and I work for the Deafblind Advocacy Group in Victoria. My question is, I'm wondering if you're aware that the TAFE course for Auslan here in Victoria has been closed, and that happened last year. It's quite disappointing and quite frustrating for us, and it's just because around Australia we don't have enough education and qualifications around Auslan qualifications. Also, if we don't have the education and qualifications around Auslan, that means we have a lack of resources in terms of Auslan interpreters and one-to-one support workers. And that comes back to the RMIT TAFE course in regards to the interpreting as well. So that's alarming for us, the deafblind community, but in regards to our future, what will happen to our support. So I'd like to know what you think will happen for our future.
Well, I am aware of this issue. And thank you very much. We had a great meeting beforehand and a great exchange, and thank you for coming to meet with me and Jenny and for giving us an insight into your world and the services and supports you need. It was a really unique opportunity for us. I am aware that there has been this cutback. We talked more broadly then about TAFE cutbacks and some of the things that have happened. And I know that there is some work happening on this, and Jim, you might be in a position to refer to some of the things we're trying to see the Victorian State Government do in this area.
Well, if I can just reiterate how important this course is. For those of you who can't see the interpreting going on down the front here, there are an amazing group of interpreters providing a very, very skilled, I really mean this, they're all looking shy up the front here now while I say this, give them a big clap. part of the wider world can actually say what it is that they feel and think every day of their lives. And without these wonderful interpreters, of course, their lives are so much more constrained. So we will do everything we possibly can to make sure that we can have enough of these interpreters to give people who are deafblind the opportunity to participate in our society, which is their right.
Thank you. Thank you. I know that there are so many hands, but we are actually over time, and I think that that is a wonderful note to end on. And thank you very much for raising that question. To everybody who's still got a question, we do try and find ways of following up. Thank you for coming along this evening. Thank you for the spirit in which people have participated. I think we've got through a broad range of issues, and I've very much enjoyed the conversation. So thank you for joining us, and I'll hand back over now to your local Member of Parliament, Mike Simon.
Just in finishing, thank you, Prime Minister, for coming to our electorate to show your support to the community here in Deakin. Thank you to all the Cabinet Ministers and all the other Ministers and Parliamentary Secretaries that we have up here on the table for your time and your interest in the issues raised in our community. You've been generous with your time. It's most appreciated. Of course, there are people who have further questions, and between my office and the people that are organising the event here, hopefully we are able to accommodate all those at a later date. I'd especially like to thank everyone who's here tonight. Those of you who haven't got a seat and stood patiently at the back, and those of you that have got a seat, thank you for your interest in the process of government. It's always heartening as a local member to see how many people care about the decisions that government makes and are prepared to have input into that. And I'd like to say that is our night. Ringwood Community Cabinet has been very successful, and as I say, to see so many people here is a great reflection on our community. I'd ask that everyone remain seated while the Prime Minister and the Ministers leave the room, and could I ask for a round of applause while the official party leaves the stage. Thank you.
To